born Gabriel Uche Amanyi is a musician and producer, widely known for his eccentric dress sense and also his style, controversial lyrics, and of course, newsworthy identity.
He has been described as one of the world's weirdest singers, and he gave us a performance just minutes ago on the show.
Yeah, well, that's what
we're talking about.
That's so huge, though. Yeah.
Let's talk about that song. You know, it had more. How would I put it now? It had a little bit more melody. Like yeah, I felt like it more song, than the normal. You know, the normal yeah. Terry J and all of that. Was that what you were going for when you wrote that song?
Well, it has to do with the feeling, the way I actually do my songs based on how I feel. You know, I get inspired by my environment. I don't write, so anyhow it comes to my mind. The period I did that song was when I got my Ferrari. So okay. That was how I felt. If you listen to the song, it just sounds like a gospel song.
Yeah, yeah, it has flow, it has melody, it has flow. Yeah.
It's a far cry from Free Madness. We all know we all know how Free Madness came about, where some people were supposed to use that beat, they went out for a smoke, and then you just jumped on it and it became a hit.
I didn't plan that, you know, it just came up, you know. It's actually one of the songs I record before I put an artist on the song. You know, before I get you on the song, I always get the effects down, the auto tunes and all that. Then I test the auto tune to get the right key. So that's how I did the Free Madness of the thing.
And
it just went viral itself.
How did you feel the first time you heard that your song was already more or less by Nigerian standard platinum? How did you feel?
Well, I was so excited, though. You know, it was a one of a kind of feeling. You know, it was like it was the first time, so I was opportuned to feel that way. Yeah.
Wow.
Agree. Well, now prior to this time, you've stated that people should not judge you according to what you say in your music and according to your past. But you know that's very hard.
Yeah, it's hard because we're in Nigeria.
Yeah, because apart from that, I think it's a general thing. It's cosmopolitan. Like I think that look at it this way. In your song, you're talking about your Ferrari. You bought a Ferrari, and then you spoke about it.
Yeah.
So if somebody sees you say, madness, and this guy, let me say they mad, though.
Yeah, you're right.
Sure, you get my point now.
You're very right.
Why people will feel that way?
I knew it was going to be that way, you know, because at the end of the day, what you sell is what people see you for, you know. But still, we should still understand that this is not a product. This is an image, and we're in the industry where we act different scripts, you know. So I'm more like an actor.
You know, more or less like an actor.
Tomorrow you can see me like a pastor. You know?
He actually likened himself to Patience Azoko, saying the whole wickedness thing going on TV.
Like my mom didn't used to like Patience Azoko. I made her like the woman because she thought the woman was a wicked woman.
You know, affective fallacy and all of that. Okay, but then now talking about you've been someone that has been quite controversial.
Yeah.
Was that originally your plan? Do you think controversy is what sells you? Was this something you set out intentionally to do?
Well, initially it wasn't intentional, but along the line I saw that was my strength. Yeah. You know, sometimes you have the calling and you don't know.
Your calling is to be controversial.
You don't know where your power is.
Wow.
You don't understand. You are a prophet, you're a minister, but you don't know the power God has given to you. You might be a healer, you might be the pastor's preaching salvation, you know. So I got that by the Spirit.
How about the issue with the DJs? That was quite a very big one.
Yeah, that's
because I think there's some kind of controversies that come that people think it will hurt you, but then it kind of what turns out to elevate you and all of
that's
that
grace.
What did that experience do to you?
Yeah, it taught me a lot. It made me know my people, and number two, nobody's above mistake.
I think
you know, sometimes you might be tested in the public. Except if it's not your calling. If it's your calling, stand for what you are.
Now, your career is something that has always been talked about. But recently you decided to do something for street kids, like trying to get them educated. And people were like, it's a publicity stunt. And you said it wasn't. Could you shed more light on that?
Well, by God's grace, I've been doing that a long time ago. The kid, the Toby kid, just happened to be popular. So that was what got it into the media and stuff. This is my fourth child. You know, my mom has a school, so I used the opportunity to train children. I was like one of them too before, you know. So let's not talk too much about that.
Now,
it's just the beginning, I'll do more.
Last year, wanted to be, I don't know whether it's a rumor, but we did see some posters about Terry G for governor of Benue State.
Yeah, you're right.
So what happened to that?
It's not a stunt, it's the motive, you know. Don't be afraid to take any step. Just be positive. Benue State, we all hear about the crisis in Benue State. You know, I'm a youth. I've got power. I've got my fan base. By God's grace, we will try as much as possible to impact positively to the youth. We might not be the winner, but we're part of the winners.
Don't you think that starting from a small, some people would say maybe a council, local government council chairman, or maybe, you know, the House of Reps and all that. Do you think that being going for a governorship race is a big
I'm even bigger than the governor. That's the problem. I'm bigger than the governor. I have power than the governor of Benin State.
So, but then now, as an entertainer, don't you think? Do you think you have to go into politics to cause a change? Don't you think that as an entertainer,
you can
effect change,
of course,
in your own way,
which I am doing already.
Okay.
I do a lot of stuff, a lot of charities without being on media. But the fact is, if you are not on the media, people won't see your motive. You know, so I took that step. I know it was a big gut, you know.
So what's the situation now? Have you picked up a nomination? Have you picked up the form? Have you joined the party?
I picked up a form. I even have sponsors. I have people backing me up.
You picked up a form? Seriously? Yeah. Wow, that's nice.
So it's not just... you thought I was kidding.
I know about this. So what I'm saying is that...
It's a bold step.
I have a friend. I've had people who just put up a poster and just use it for, you know, if they don't go to actually pick up a form, join a party. Are you in a party? Do you want to tell us?
My party.
Your party? Yeah. What's the name of the party?
No, let me not disclose it
yet. Okay, but in due time, we'll get to it so that we know what to
very
people
soon,
that want to
you're going to
vote
be part
for
of
you.
Our sponsors as well.
No problem.
How earlier you were talking about the fact that the Terry G in private is different from Terry G in public.
Yeah.
Now, there's something that always stands out when Terry G is mentioned, your mom. You love your mom so much, you're always talking about her. Trust What's your me. Relationship with her like?
We all love our mom, you know, trust me. We just don't make it obvious, you know. Everybody has that deep love, you know. The opportunity for me being on Earth is number one before I appreciate any other thing in life. Mm. And my mom has done her best, she has done her part. She used the opportunity she had.
Her birthday was last Saturday, actually.
Yeah, we share the same date. Yeah, March 17th.
Wow.
Yeah, I celebrated her birthday for her. But the fact is, she's just an angel to me. We all love our mom. Let's appreciate our mom. Let's do better.
Fact, True that. True that. So let me just get back a bit to the other one. But what would you think you would do or what would you do if you were given the opportunity and you become the governor today? What would you do?
Differently.
Talking about what I'll do. Well, outside the building is quite different from inside the building. Talking about terms and conditions, you know, once you're in the house, you have to abide to a lot of things. Mm. But trust me, it's a positive move, and I'm just a very stubborn boy.
You are, we all agree.
I like to be positive. Whenever I want to do something, trust me, I'll do it. So you can't force me to do something bad. Mm. I won't do it. By God's grace, we are just trying. Anything that works, it works.
This governor thing is, from what I'm gathering now, it's actually a new thing. It's something I actually saw last year, about August last year. And to now want to be a governor, some people would say, so many entertainers going into politics. We have Desmond Elliott already living his dream, so to speak. Now, if and when you become a governor, he talked about the things you would do differently. If and when you become a governor, what changes would you affect, especially for the youth?
Well, talking about opportunities, we will give the youth opportunities when it comes to expression. You know, sometimes we have this inbuilt stuff in us and we find it so difficult to express it. And we just have a direction that the government just put us through. Like, you have to go to school when you get a certain age before you start working and all that. So they control your life for you. But I believe you can actually be very successful at a tender age. You know, it has to do with that creativity and what you have inside of you. So we can help you explore and express that.